This is the number one cocktail in Providence.
It's definitely my favorite. Hi. Say hi, babe.
Hello.
It is February something something. I know it's a Saturday. And we are 10th. February 10th. And we're just spending the weekend around our little city. I always find it funny, the TikToks that I get served that are about, like, you know, moving out of those main cities and coming into secondary cities, because that's definitely something that we did, moving from Boston to Providence. So I thought I'd take you around a weekend in Providence and share with you what we do. So I think today we're kind of just winging it, to be quite honest with you. We went to the gym this morning as per usual, so that took a lot of our time. We are walking our Odin bugs, and then we'll go where the wind blows. So I'll check in once we figure out what that is.
I went in there and I said, boom, boom, bam.
Rich said that this is the number one cocktail in Providence.
It's my favorite cocktail in Providence. Yeah, the paper plane at Bellini's.
And I
overall experience, the taste, just the feel.
I love it too. This is like one of our favorite places. This is our like go-to spot in the city. And I really like their, what is this called?
Sacatini.
Sacatini. With a little bit of splash prosecco, which they forgot, but that's okay. And yeah, and we're just hanging out here for a little bit longer, and then we're going to see where we go. I don't know where to look. Not here. I think I need to look at that green.
But. Yeah. That's where we're.
We'll finish up and then we'll check in after we're done. We just left Bellini's, as you saw. It's always a good time. We never can complain. I think it's honestly the best place in the city. There's a few other places that are really nice, but we love that especially. So I think we're getting a little bit hungry, so we may head home, eat something.
It's one of our, at least one of our top two favorite spots. I think if we had to put an official list together, Bellini's would be hard pressed to not be number one, but I think Dolores's puts in quite a competition, that they're a very competitive number two.
Yeah, it's definitely a different vibe. It's not as like an elevated experience. I mean, it's Mexican food, right? It's still very beautiful, but it's just a little bit more casual. There's also another place called Persimmons that's really good, that I personally really love.
Persimmons doesn't like to feed you,
but it's like small plates. It's very so. It's so bright today.
Persimmon, great place, beautiful atmosphere. Food is absolutely delicious.
I like small plates. Like,
I just can't give big stars to a place that you spend a fortune and leave hungry.
It helps you to learn restraint, okay? Know when you're full. That's the kind of restaurants I like. So yeah, I would say Persimmons. And then, I don't know, there's really cool like cocktail places, a lot of bakeries, a lot of cafes. Like Providence is really surprisingly very filled with a lot of places to eat at. So I think we're very lucky for this to be such a small city, yet have so much to offer in terms of restaurants.
Very diverse. I'd say it's like its main competition is in its casual dining. That's where it's really competitive. Mm. All the food is a vast selection, and you can find whatever you want to eat. Really good food. For a great competitive price, but it's a bit more casual. Whereas when you're looking for more of an elevated experience, more of a elevated dinner, then that's where it can sometimes
be limited.
It'll still have options available to you. It just won't have an endless selection like, say, New York. But
still, it has what it has, and I don't know, we're satisfied with it, and we're big foodies, I would say, when we go out. At home, we're usually just, like, very maintain our diet, but when we go out, we like to enjoy really good food. So, we were really in the downtown area, which has a lot of cool bars and restaurants, but it's quite small. Maybe we'll go down there this afternoon so you can check it out again and kind of see the buildings. The architecture is amazing. And if even more restaurants came and even more retail stores would come, I really feel like this city would completely blow up. Like, I think in the next couple years, there is potential for, obviously not for this small city to be a major city, but definitely more of a attraction than it is now.
I think the potential for the city, it comes from actually the pandemic. There was a big influx of some big money over the pandemic as people from Boston and New York really tried to space out and spread out, and they started to really consider the tertiary markets similar to us, and they came and they bought a house and they brought all of their money and influence with them. And I think Providence really saw a big influx at that point, but like anything, it's going to take some time for that to really start to spread and you start to see like the results of that. Providence is, although it's a city, I'd really say it's like comprised a lot of blue collar people. But when you get a sudden change or a big influx of, white collar, wealthier, educated families, then the businesses and the experiences around the city will start to change, but slowly it'll take time. once they start to realize that their audience, that the market out there has changed. So you can see the potential for the city in over the next couple of years.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, it still has its familiar feel.
Yeah, it still has its familiar feel, and I think that's why, going back to, like, it does have a lot of restaurants and bars to go to, is because it has two really major universities here. So there's RISD, Rhode Island School of Design, which is known worldwide, and then also an Ivy League school of Brown University. So imagine the students and the parents that come. So obviously they need to have restaurants around that can offer them something, right? So that's why Providence is such a great city, in that it offers you that and gives you the opportunity to go into those, like, nice restaurants and bars and just places. So I think what we'll do now is head home, chill out for a bit. It's Saturday. We kind of want to just take it easy, and then if we're up for it, maybe we'll take you guys out later on to see more of it, see more of the city. But we will check in soon. One of our favorite coffee shops called Ceremony.
Your favorite. Definitely.
It's definitely my favorite. Definitely my favorite. It is owned by, I believe, a Japanese woman. Is she Korean or Japanese? No, for sure Japanese. Yeah, definitely Japanese, but it's so cute. It's like the perfect place. Their coffees, lattes, anything you want is really cute and also very Instagrammable. You can get these, like, cool little coffee beers and little, like, Japanese treats, and I don't know, there's just so many good things. And it's also, like, the perfect place if you just want to do some work but you want to be out among the people. It's a perfect place. It's actually a street over from Thayer Street, which is pretty popular street for a lot of college students in Providence. Because RISD and Brown University is literally a couple streets up. There's a lot of dormitories around. This is a dormitory that we're passing here. So yeah, so really cool. We just went in because our friend really wanted us to pick up, I think, a children's book that they saw on their Instagram. So we did that. This, what was the title? Taste of Lunar Year. They just had a little boy, so maybe that's why they wanted it. I don't know. Anyways, we are heading home now, but I'm so happy that I was able to show you that place, because it's honestly one of my favorite coffee shops in Providence.